think once she sees the work, she will agree. There's a powerful full group of investment real estate professionals here today. They will have 5 minutes to introduce themselves and what services they offer. They will come up in the order that they are listed on the following slide. So at this time, I'm going to yield the podium, and that's the order. 5 minutes each, and thank you for coming to this event.
Good afternoon. I think you're gonna really enjoy this. So, I mean, I feel fortunate just to be here too, because I'm here to learn too. But my name is Tinker Quesada. This is Casey Quesada. We're father-daughter team here with First American Title. I've been in the title industry out here over 40 years, and Casey's been working with me just a little over a year, and she's had 5 years experience in the escrow business. So we kind of cover the full facet of the real estate transactions that that you may come through. Our office, we can close exchanges, we can close commercial properties, we cover everything. So whether it's development, residential, of course, refinance, we cover it all. And if any of you guys get have questions that you, on the title side or any, actually anything, we get questions about it, any and everything every day. You know, what's the best chocolate in the on aisle four? Just call them. But give us a ring. We're here to help, and we're here to learn and gain more business, just like all of us here. So we appreciate Ernest inviting us, and Marie, thank you much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Hello, I'm Scott Davis with First American Exchange. I actually work for the same company as Casey and Tinker as well. Glad to be out here today. Ernest invited me out here. I'm just strictly in the exchange division, where we trade the investment property for investment property for the purpose of tax deferral. So I don't know how many of you have been participated in a 1031 exchange.
Okay.
All right, fantastic. So we have presentations for it. We usually do spend about an hour on them, but it's, you know, it's a way to defer your capital gains and reinvest that capital gains into your next investment property. It's just a fantastic tool. If you're in investments, you really need to be looking at 1031 exchange. And just give me a call anytime. And like I said, I work for the same company as Tinker and Casey, and look forward to being able to help you with any of your exchange information. I got a flyer back here with the basics, the bottom line, how to put an exchange together. And love to work with you, and appreciate you having me out here.
All right, everybody, my name is Drew Rashal. I'm a business banking relationship manager with U.S. Bank. I specialize in commercial lending with a primary focus in investment properties. So a lot of you people, if you don't know about U.S. Bank, why U.S. Bank as your lender? First and foremost, we've been around since 1863, over 150 years in business, and we're a highly ethical bank. For 8 years running, we've been considered one of the highest ethical rated banks in the nation. And we offer extremely competitive rates and terms, as well as no bank fees or points, which a lot of our competitors don't. So, and one thing also is that we have a high, big presence in the country, as well as within the state and Inland Empire. So we are a bank that you can definitely trust us for your financing needs. So what I would like to do is, at the end of this all, I'll give you my card. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask, and I would love to work with you on your future investment needs. Thank you.
Hey guys, Johnny Rojas. I don't think you'll have any problem hearing me. I used to be an infantry sergeant 47 pounds ago. So I'm with Accelerate Capital. We're out of Newport Beach. I'm one of the founding members of that company. I was a janitor, coffee maker, all that other stuff when we started it up. We've grown to a pretty sizable company now. For those of you who know where the Google building is in Newport Beach, there's these two glass towers across the street from them. We occupy the 8th floor and the 3rd floor of that building. So I thank Ernest for inviting us here. We are traditional lenders. We do your conventional, your FHA, and your VA. However, our number one claim to fame is we were the first non-QM company in the United States that started originating in 2015. Non-QM, you can consider it as the new subprime or the new investment style, which is why I'm here to talk to you guys. You have essentially three different options and way to go when you're dealing with investment or financing. You can either go the regular traditional route, which is full dot banking, et cetera, et cetera. US Bank is phenomenal at that piece. And they are very strong in those product lines as we are as well. And then either that or you have to go hard money if you don't qualify, which you're shaking hands at five, you know, anywhere 3 to 5 points in fees, 10 to 12% rate, or you just don't buy. So we are the option in the middle, meaning that we can do things like no doc loans for investment properties where you don't qualify, your income doesn't qualify in case your portfolio is or your taxes are kind of funky, but we go off of the property itself. We're looking at the income that the property generates. And right now we have programs where it doesn't matter if it debt services or not, it's called a DSCR, debt service coverage ratio, meaning does if your mortgage is $3,000, does it make $3,000 in rent? Now the answer is we don't care how much it makes, just get it in there. We can do 10% down on investment properties, which is unheard of. You know, most of the time you're shaking hands at 25% or above, you know, so 10% down. We also, you can use gift funds, which you can't do on investment properties. If mom, dad, brother, partners, or whatever, you're using their money to buy, we allow for that, you know. We also have bank statement programs that are priced better. So you guys gotta ask me, what's the catch? I just told you, it's between hard money and between traditional lending. So if traditional loans right now are charging 6% in rate, we're gonna shake hands around the 7% rate range or 7 to 8, all right? And then, so when people say, oh my gosh, look at those rates, look at the payment. Look at the payment first, because you'll realize if you're not able to qualify using traditional income, you have to do what? You have to pay taxes to show income on your taxes so we can use that, and that could be anywhere $50,000, $60,000, $80,000 a year you gotta pay versus paying $200 or $300 a month more, which is about $3,000 a year, which when you deal with your tax expert, gets you allows you to recover some of that money. So it's a much, much cheaper, much wiser, long game option. The majority of the guys who make up our portfolios and that are investors. I have a guy right now that we're working with, he doesn't even know how many properties he owns. Somewhere between 50 to 60 properties, and he's buying and selling them all the time. So the application he gives us today will not be the same application we fund on in 20 days later. So we're like, I don't wanna look at your taxes, Chris, just give me the deal. And he's like, all right, cool, I got three more. I know you have three more, just shut up and give them to us. Great guys, great products, great abilities, and that's what we're here. So I have some flyers in the back for you. My team is here with me, one of my LOs here, our marketing group leader here as well for the company. You guys have any questions, we're here for you.
For random hard money.
Hard money right now. I just talked to some investors. They're shaking hands around 11 to 13 these days. So that's where they're at. He says they're going to keep going north. So I do have friends in low places that I keep contact with, and we keep each other accountable. All right, that's it. Johnny Rojas, 608 Cap.
Been working in technology for about 45 years, and there's glitches sometimes. I want to thank those real estate resources for coming and see if this thing is frozen or what's going on. There we go. There's a delay on this machine. This is not mine. All right, so this is my opportunity to introduce this fantastic man over here who's very humble, as you know, very high energy, as you know, many of you know, but he is an amazing man and he's also my friend. So I'm gonna read, because I get very emotional when I start talking about him, and then I'm gonna move on. All right. Ernest Livingstone is the owner of Livingstone Realty Group located in Riverside, California. He has over 22 years of experience selling residential, commercial, and income properties. Ernest has been involved in acquisitions and sales of shopping centers, trailer parks, multifamily units, raw land, and construction of new home developments. He also has a property management company serving Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino counties. Ernest lives in Riverside, California, and enjoys working with his many clients and associates in this ever-changing world of real estate. For information, my wife and I are clients. Ernest has helped us sell two investment and two primary residences. He also helped us purchase two investments and one primary. The investments were 1031 exchanges. He continues to manage the most recent acquisition. I am proud to be one of his clients and honored to be one of his friends. This time I'd like to introduce Ernest and open the slideshow that he'll be using. Ernest.
Thank you, Rufus. It's actually nice to have a good friend like Rufus, known him a long time, and it's also nice the fact that he's a Rams season ticket holder, and he's also a pilot, and he has his own plane. And here's the interesting thing, he'll call me, I'm at the office, hey, it's Rufus, yeah, what's up? I'm here at the San Bernardino Airport, come on and meet me, we'll go to Catalina Island. Boom. He's in Riverside Airport. Hey, come over here. We'll go to lunch to Los Angeles. He does that all the time, so I appreciate those invites.
All right. Good. Is there room for a co-pilot?
Well, I appreciate everyone for their time and coming out here. A lot of you in such notice and supporting the event. You know, this event, this seminar, I was thinking about this and I thought, I want to do a seminar. And it's not about my company, it's not about selling anything. It's just about presenting a seminar that, you know, we're gonna talk to a very unique person, woman that is very successful. And she owns every type of imaginable property, commercial, multifamily, the whole nine yards. Her portfolio is Riverside County and San Diego County. That's where most of her portfolio is. And what I thought would be great and unique is to have her perspective, but because I think the unique part about Marie Dore is the fact that she manages all her own properties. And they're extensive, and they're in very different cities, but she has a way to manage them, and it's very unique. Now, obviously, I'm a property manager. I can talk about the laws and, you know, the challenges for property management. And, you know, bottom line, I know what my owners want. They want to make a profit on their investment, and they don't want to get sued. So I thought Marie would be great to share, you know, her experience and her secrets and her success over the years in building a large portfolio and managing them. She owns properties in San Diego, Golden Hill, Old Town, La Jolla, Pacific Beach, Coronado Island, all over. And, you know, and some in different type of neighborhoods, you know, some lower priced homes, some upper end homes. Again, I think what's unique about Marie Dore is the fact that she knows her laws, she knows property management, she's built housing, quality housing for people, and she's created it, and she rents quality housing for her tenants. And I think she knows probably every single tenant by name, right, Marie? So anyway, on that note, I want to welcome her and to the seminar. And Marie, if you could introduce yourself, that would be great.
Well, thank you, Ernest. You've overdone it with the introduction because I won't be able to deliver all that you said, but I'm going to do my best. It's so nice to be back in the Riverside area. It's my neighborhood where I grew up in Corona, and I really spent a lot of time coming to Riverside because this is where I ended up getting the money to get through my education. Some of you are probably not old enough to know about the Ruben's restaurant that was on University Avenue. Anybody remember Ruben's? God, you guys are, oh, thank you. I know I'm old, but I thought, is everybody else gone? Okay, well, I worked at this Ruben's restaurant. There used to be a Coco's on the top, and there was a Ruben downstairs, and that was kind of like the nicer restaurant. Well, that restaurant ended up paying for me to get my master's program in school of administration and 1 year of completely paying my student teaching. You don't get paid to student teach. You have to go and volunteer. Well, a lot of us don't have money, so that's how I did it. Thank God, and I kind of was hoping there would be a landmark. You know, Marie got her education by working here, but there's nothing there. I also worked at the Marie Counter Pie Shop, so I'm very familiar with the area. And that's where I met Marie Callender herself, if you can believe that, and her son, Don. You probably didn't know that either, right? But they left me a large tip, and I thought, someday I want to leave somebody a large tip. And she said to me that she wished me a bright future, and I think that was kind of a blessing, especially coming from a woman at that time that didn't have the opportunities that we have today for women. I was hired by the Coronado School District to teach a sixth grade class. I was assigned to a new school called John Adams Elementary. That's an interesting part of the story was that I ended up with my youngest brother, one of my youngest brothers, in my classroom. And it was weird because every parent showed up except one to meet your teacher night. That parent didn't show up. I was very upset because I always want 100% on everything. That parent, my mother and father, stayed home, and I had to be there with my brother alone. So all I can say is you do not want to have your brother in your classroom. It's not a good idea. So that November, I decided to find a place to live, and I wanted to find a neighborhood that I thought would be conducive to nice neighbors and a house. I spotted in a nice little golf course area it needed some TLC. It was nice, but it needed work. And after realizing that I was going to be paid a salary of $6,095 for 12 months, you do get vacations as a teacher, but that was my salary for 1 year. Think about that. That wasn't that long ago. I'm not going to tell you how old I am. So I went to my banker and the bank manager to see if I could qualify to get a home loan. To my surprise, he said, "We do not give home loans to unmarried women." I just couldn't accept that as an answer. Remember, this is 1975. So I began to use my creative thinking. I thought, what can I do to get that loan, because I want a house. I don't want to rent an apartment. So I decided to talk to my boyfriend. I said, "Would you mind getting engaged? And would you mind marrying me in 3 months?" And he looked at me. I said, "Honestly, it's not going to cost you a penny. But I said, you're going to go with me to the bank. You're going to say you're going to be my husband in 3 months, and I'm going to get a home." Well, I took him to the bank with me, and I said, "This is my future husband." I was approved for the loan. My first home. I was all excited. I got a home. I quickly filed a quit claim deed, and we still remained friends, but after I had my home, it was kind of like it didn't work out anymore. I don't know why, but it didn't. So I had my first house, and I was excited. But $230 a month on the mortgage?
Wow.
Yeah, so my friends said, to my friends that were teachers would say, "How are you going to do that, Marie? How are you going to afford payments like that?" And I said, well, I responded, "I'm going to teach during the week, and on the weekends, guess where I'm going to be? I'm going to be waitressing at Ruben's." Believe me, it wasn't easy, but being a waitress on the weekends. But one day I was so exhausted from working with the two jobs, I'm a new teacher, I'm trying to be creative, I'm trying to do a good job with the kids, that I was so exhausted that I got pulled over by the police going home from Ruben's restaurant. Because you gotta remember, I worked in the cocktail lounge, and no teacher is supposed to be in a cocktail lounge. I never told anybody, and I prayed every day that a parent didn't show up saying, "Oh, this is my kid's teacher." But it didn't happen, so everything went well. But I was happy because it was worth it. I got my first home. Remember, again, nothing is easy. When you're going to go for something, you gotta work hard. So I forwarded 2 years. I've been in my home. I've cleaned it up. I've looked around to make sure that it's going to be a good deal for the future, because I was not just satisfied with that one home, but I enjoyed having my own home. So my neighbor next door came over and said to me, you know, remember when Orange County, I don't know if you guys are too young, but anyway, Orange County, a lot of people would come into Corona to buy homes because they were cheaper. Some of you remember that. So at that time, that's when it was going on. So I bought my home, and this neighbor said to me, my relative friend is coming from Orange County and he needs a home, and he likes yours because it has a nice little place in the back where he can put his RV. And I said, well, he said, are you willing to sell? I said, well, if the price is right? So he said, I said, well, what's he willing to offer me? He says, $139,000. Remember, I paid $29,000 two years ago for this home. I had it cleaned up, I had it painted, I put a nice concrete pad in the back for his RV, which it ended up working for him. And so he said the improvements were perfect. I gained $110,000 just there and then. You gotta remember, money was worth something. It's not worth that much today, but it was worth a lot then. So in 2 years, I gained $110,000. I love teaching school, but this was a great Monopoly game. I loved Monopoly growing up. I stayed up all night until I beat them to the ground to get those hotels. I wanted those hotels. It really paid off. It really paid off, I thought to myself. I like this. It's my very first investment. Set a goal and just do it.
Ray, can you hand me my phone over there? I'm sorry. Yeah, thank you. Good. I want to talk, Maria, if you could address, I talk to a lot of people that are looking to buy an investment property, or second or third. They're always asking me, you know, where should I start looking, what do you look for? You know, obviously you want a return on the investment. The challenge, especially with multifamily today, is a lot of properties are being sold, but the return on the investment is not great. You know, one of the problems is the rental values. You know, the rents are low. You buy a property, your rent's low, it's going to take some time to get those up to where it should be. And so people are always asking me, what's your secret? And so I asked Maria, I said, Maria, can you talk today about selecting the right property for an investment?
Well, the first thing I would say, if you don't have a good broker to help you go out and do that, they would do good homework for you. I always believe I have to do my homework. I don't care what the broker says. I'm going to see it. I'm going to look at it. I'm going to make sure that there's some value there. But they can help you search for the deals. And I know that I've had some brokers that have come up with incredible deals that even I didn't know how worthwhile it would be in the future. But I know that finding properties that may not look very pretty, you know, they need facelifts, they need paint, they need cleanup, they need their yards cleaned up, fencing. Finding a property that you could add two apartments rather than just one. In other words, I've had two. Actually get much more money by having that than have a two-bedroom. Yeah. And I'm close to the university, and every group of kids wants to be there. Yeah. And so then you got a quiet place becomes wild.
Right. This is Kemper 30. These are, again, this is old Google pictures. I didn't have time to go out to take pictures, but this is Kemper 32 units. She's completely remodeled. I think about how much, what percent, 80, 90%?
At least 85 to 90% now.
Yeah, of all those.
And I will not kick anybody out, and that's why I haven't done the rest. They've been there. Some have been 18.
Do you have an in-house property manager?
Yes. You when you have 15 units or more, you legally have to have a manager on site and live there.
And so that's Kemper. I want to show you this one. This is a great property. This is an ocean beach, and it ocean views. And it's three single family, three homes. And also it has down here, it has a basement unit as well, apartment down here. What I liked about this property, I've been out to visit it, is it's got banana trees and mangoes that are actually growing. and she put a jacuzzi up here, a miniature golf course. You got a palapa with a bar, right? A tequila bar. And
No, it's a bar, right.
But it's pretty impressive property. Marie, do you want to talk about anything real quick on that?
Well, the unit, there's a unit underneath this house, which at first I thought, it's kind of...
Right there.
It's kind of, yeah, you can't see the door. You'd have to go further. There's a house in the middle and a house on the top. There's three, and on the bottom there's a studio that has that one garage on the end. The funny thing about it is I got a teacher that had grandchildren in OB, but she couldn't afford to rent a house. So she came there and she says, will you let me do what I want? I said, being that you're a teacher, I'll trust you a little bit, but call me when you're doing something odd. So she went in there and made this place. I couldn't even believe it was my rental. That's how creative she was, and she's been there now since the time I bought it.
Right.
And good tenants.
Yeah, and you know, Evers, this is a high rent area, especially ocean views from the properties.
And owning a house, if people want
this
that.
This is property in La Jolla by Wind and Sea down there in La Jolla. It's two blocks from the ocean. It's like great neighborhood. I mean, obviously, high-end rents at this. There's studios. What do you, anything to say about that property, Marie, in La Jolla?
All the men that live there are surfing every single day. You roll down the street and you're in the water, and all the homes on all sides, other than the apartments that we have, are all multi-million dollar homes. And some of them are breathtaking homes. So you've got the ocean there. I did not know this area existed. I've been living in San Diego for 25 years. I did not know until I went to see this property. And I said, I don't know what's up there, but I'm buying it. You go down, it's got the most pristine view of the ocean. It's got a place for you to be able to pack a lunch. It's got grassy area, and then you got a place where you can surf, and then you got the rocks that you go. It's kind of like Las Gaviotas. I don't know if you've been, many of you have been there before. It's in Paso Rosarito Beach, and it's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's kind of like that, but it is, the tenants are wonderful. I have people that make good money, attorneys and that kind of stuff. They want a good place to live.
High rent district. Yeah. Kansas, this is a real unique property. I would just say it's a very old property. You can see it there. And how many units are there, Marie?
There are, when I bought it, there were four. Now there are five.
Okay, we'll leave it at that. Five, completely remodeled. I think it was built, it's Spanish style, it was built, what, in the early, about 1920s, 30s? 30s, I think.
Probably mid-20s,
yeah.
Because there used to be a bowling alley behind it, and they still have the sign up there to show that's where the bowling alley was, and that was in the early 1900s.
Yeah.
But it's old, but, okay, yeah. And that's another one.
Okay, this is the Coronado Island. This is D Avenue in Coronado. Again, older picture. She's done a lot of work to this property. It has military, because you know, you get a lot of pilots that want to stay there and stuff like that, right, Marie?
It's a great place to live. It's expensive to live there, but military, that they pay whatever they need to pay for housing. They're a couple of a husband and wife doctor, and I keep saying, why do they live here? Why wouldn't they go get their own home? But they love living there.
Yeah.
And if you look at the whole property, there's buildings in the back, and we are so close to the landing that has the most beautiful view of San Diego.
Yeah.
You'd have to travel millions of miles to get a view like
that.
Yeah,
you gotta check it out when you're there at Coronado.
Yep.
We're gonna take a few minute break, just 5 minutes, and then we're gonna go quick to kind of wrap it up. But we're gonna go next, you got an idea of what she owns, so we're gonna go through some of the issues currently in property management, in the laws. We're gonna go through some maintenance issues. We're gonna talk about security deposits, stuff like that.